Hello and welcome to Disc Review, the podcast that goes track by track through a different album each week.
And we're your hosts, Max and Matt. Join us as we explore some of our favorite records.
No, I'm a fan, I swear.
I feel like I've become a music normie.
I'm tired of being Mr. Positive Guy.
Dude, that's not human.
This is certifiably the most boring album I've ever heard.
And there's a reason they don't do it, because it's terrible.
We hope you enjoy the show. Let's get into it. Hello everyone, welcome to Disc Review. Guys, today we're going to be talking about GGBBXX by Lany, their most recent album. Matt, I gotta ask, what do you think those letters stand for?
Well, if I had to go with the most common uses of those letters on their own, I'd say good game. BB usually stands for a baby, and X stands for kisses, right?
Yes.
But I'm sure that's not what they mean. I'm just saying that's the most common understanding of those.
I figured it was gotta go baby XX.
That works. Kisses. Yeah, that works.
But good game baby is way funnier.
It is funnier. It's not good game. I'm just saying that's the most common. When I see GG, it's what I think of. But yeah, I think that makes sense. I really like that title. I think it's unique. It's something different, obviously. And I think the album art goes really well with it. I think the album art is really cool.
Oh, yeah. It's super cool. It's like got this modern art thing going on.
Yeah.
Little bit of abstract, but you can tell, you know, it's the head of a person. And yeah, I think it's super cool. Guys, if you are tuning in now and you don't know much about this podcast, I'll give you a little rundown of what we're going to do today. So we're going to start off by talking about this Lany album. We're going to go track by track and talk about what we like and dislike about each song, end it off by, you know, talking about the album as a whole. And then we will have a little game, which is the first time we're playing this game. It's called Matthew McConaughey or Lyrics, where I'm going to tell my co-host Matt a phrase, and he has to guess whether that's something that Matthew McConaughey said or if that is a song lyric. And I'll tell you who the song lyrics are going to be by in a little bit.
But sounds good.
Yeah, why don't we jump into this album? It starts with the song Get Away. Damn, how could anybody let you get away, get away, get away? When I saw Lany live like a year and a half ago, this was the first song they played, and I was so blown away. It was so powerful and fun. It sounds a little low-key on the album, but it went crazy live. And I think this is a great opener for the album. It lets the listener know that this album is going to be just as good as the last one. I can't believe how quickly they're able to put out great albums. I mean, this came out, what, just a year after the last one?
Yeah, I think so. And, I mean, you said kind of low key. I mean, that last album's very low key, and that's intentional. I think they carry a lot of that here. It's still a little bit low key, but in this album's different because it's got a little bit more energy and a lot more synths, and which is what they're known for, as their synths, right? That kind of music. So they're bringing that back, and you're right. They wrote a really good record here. There's so many good songs, and this first track is super strong. I think the perfect way to start off the album. I usually think openers, while I think they're fun, are not the best songs on the album. But this is one of the best songs. Like, this is one of the best openers I've seen. It just gets you right into that style with such a good song with those just super catchy melodies, which I'll say over and over again because Lany is really good at that. This is just classic Lany.
I agree. Yeah, it's definitely one of the best. The next song is Up to Me. This song has some great 80s synths that make it a lot of fun. The verses are really solid, but the song really shines in the chorus. That's something I'm going to be mentioning a lot as well. It's about a guy who says that if it was up to him, they'd still be together, but other things have gotten in the way of the relationship. And my favorite part of the song is him telling this girl that his band has finally made it and how she always believed that he would.
I agree. I think one thing that's always interesting to me about Lany is their lyrics and the way they can kind of take a fresh new perspective on relationships, which, you know, most artists are talking about relationships and love, and Lany's no exception, but I think they're really good at finding these unique takes. And this is a good example of that, where it's not just, oh, I love you. It's all this, all these feelings, all these emotions wrapped up in, we can't be together, but it's not up to me. Like you said in the title. So I really do like this song. I think this is one of the singles, and it's one of the best songs on the record.
Yeah, it's really good. And I think that the reason they're able to find those, different takes on relationships is because they're actually writing honest lyrics. Like, they're not just saying things to say them. I think that their singer really writes from his heart, and that gives some really unique takes on love. The next song is Never Mind, Let's Break Up. Never mind, let's break up. And I think this one was a single. It definitely has that big single energy. It
Yeah.
has lines that you can kind of just latch on to and never forget. Like when he says, "I thought about giving you one more chance. Never mind, let's break up," which is where the song gets its name. It's very back and forth, which I think a lot of people can relate to when it comes to relationships that really could go one way or the other.
Yeah, I mean, they're not always writing heartfelt love songs, which most of the time they are, but this is like a breakup song, right? Obviously in the title, but Lany's always done those kind of songs well too, kind of bringing a little bit more different emotions, some frustration, some anger with how what's going on in the relationship, but kind of makes it, I just feel like Lany is really good at making their songs wholesome. It's like, this ain't working, let's break up. And that's the best way to approach things. If it's not working, break up, and that's fine. And I'll say that again on this record, because there's a lot of really genuine, heartfelt stuff here on these next tracks.
The next track is DNA. Sorry, I call again when you don't pick up and tell you you're beautiful, but probably too This song is
much.
really sweet. I think it was also a single. I said this before, but the chorus, is just the best part of this song. They write great choruses that just sound so cool and interesting while still sounding really honest and from the heart. They really know how to pick their hooks as well. When he says it's just not in my DNA to love you only halfway. I mean, who can forget that line? It's perfect and it's really catchy.
You're right, they're really good at writing those one-liner hooks. I think a lot of their songs on this record have that, and they really center the song around that. And it works. I mean, those lines really are that catchy, and they can just build, a really good song around that. It's not like any part is really lacking. You're right, the choruses are always the strongest, but I would never say their verses are lacking at all. They make the whole song really good, and their production on some of these other tracks are insane. They're some of the best music producers I've seen, to be honest. But yeah, when it comes to this song specifically, I think if I had to pick like a Lany song for someone who's never heard them, who just want to know their style, I'd probably pick this. This is just like everything that Lany does best, just like highlighted really well. It's just kind of got it all, and I just think this song's really underrated.
Yeah, it would be a good one to show people who haven't heard of Lainey. The next one is Roll Over Baby. This one's not a bad song, but it's just not really my favorite. There's this style of song where people sing about like not wanting to go to bed angry. I don't know if you've noticed that, but I
I
feel
can,
like
I
even
think I know
though
which one you're talking about. It's probably Set It Off. But I think I get what you're saying. This song wasn't it for me at the beginning when I first started listening to this record when it came out like a year ago, whatever. But man, the more I listen to it, the more that it's grown on me. It really has. It's grown on me. I think this song just has like uses that premise way better. I think the lines are a lot more clever. I think Come Meet Me Halfway, from your side of the bed is just so much, it's just a better take because it's about like coming together. It's not like, oh, I need to just apologize and do it. It's like, let's meet halfway, and that is how you resolve problems in a relationship. For that reason, I just find it like a lot more genuine and real, and for that I think it grows on me, even if it's not, the catchiest song on the record or whatever. I think that redeeming quality, I think, makes it still a really solid track.
Yeah, I would probably like this one more if I wasn't already tainted with songs with the same message that just
Yeah.
aren't very good.
But this is
But
my favorite of that. But I know what you mean, 100%. It's kind of an overused trope, but I think this does it really well.
the next song is Live It Down. It's the kind of love, if you miss it up, I'll be the one, be the first to let you live
The
it
album really
down.
slows down here and brings in the emotion. The lyrics are very personal and unique. I love the line in the verse that says, "People make rockets that go to the moon, people make mistakes too."
it just shows that, like, you know, we're all capable of doing great things, but that doesn't mean that we won't mess up and fail sometimes.
I also highlighted that line. That's probably the most you stand out from the song, but I think what I just realized listening to this again was just how full this album is of just heartfelt, sincere songs, like I talked about with the last one. This is another great premise. I think that, you know, when it comes to love, and a lot of love songs, it's all about, you know, the honeymoon period where it's just this thrill and it's exciting. But I think when it comes to true love, what people really want is what's in this song, is someone who's going to let you live down your worst mistakes, because all too often people are holding over mistakes on people's heads, and it does cause a lot of emotional suffering. So just that peace and that calm of knowing that someone will forgive you, you know, obviously there are mistakes that you won't be forgiven for, like cheating, but, you know, letting you just be a person, let you be real and let you be vulnerable with someone is something I think people want with true love. And I think that highlights this really, really well on this track.
Yeah. I mean, there's a lot of components to love, right? And when you first meet someone and you're in that honeymoon phase, the main components are like attraction and excitement and stuff like that. But, you know, as it goes on, you really just want to find someone who accepts you for who you are, despite your shortcomings and your past. So I think that that's something that this song definitely touches on well. So the next song is Dancing in the Kitchen. This is a contender for my favorite on the album. It's a good one to play with your girl. Girls love dancing in the kitchen, brother.
Yeah.
I think that Lany's singer is just the corniest lover boy ever, but it's weirdly respectable.
It works.
Yeah, like this man loves to dance in the kitchen, hold open doors and meeting your parents. Those are the things he loves. Mm-hmm.
But I agree. I think this was the lead single. It's got the most streams. It really is that good of a song. It's so catchy. And I think what I appreciate about it too is it kind of telling you, hey, slow down and appreciate the little things, like is dancing in your kitchen. You know, just enjoy those fun moments, because they do matter, and they're better than you think sometimes. You think you're doing something huge, but sometimes dancing in the kitchen is the best thing you could be doing that night. And I think it just makes you appreciate that.
Yeah, I mean, this is a thing that a lot of people say. I didn't make this up, but it's really the little moments in life accumulated that make people happy. It's not like the big things. The next song is X I Never Had. This song is kind of petty and a little bit funny, but I actually like it a lot. He's just laying it down how it is. There's a girl running around talking about how he broke her heart, and he's just like, you know, we don't even really know each other that well. He admits that he didn't really put much into what they had, but that's just because he didn't think that she really cared. So, you know, it's fun.
I agree. It's a fun premise. Like I said, they're taking a new perspective on a relationship. This one, obviously, it's about, you know, a misunderstanding of, you know, what this was, and him kind of laying down his side of the story. Who's to say who's right? But, you know, we're getting his perspective, and I think it just makes it a fun listen, and on top of being really catchy. But I noted on this one just that their production really is that good. I love that guitar strum they throw in the chorus every time one of his lines starts. I think it's just those little things that add up to make these songs so good.
The next song is Somewhere. Another slower one here. At first, this one was kind of boring to me, and I do think that they could have done a little bit more with the instrumental, but I have to admit that the lyrics hit really hard, and it's very relatable.
Yeah, this definitely slows way down here. This is a really heartfelt, quiet ballad. I think they're trying to retain that low-key feel that they started on that last album. There's another track that's really low-key like this, but I think I like this one a little better. Like you said, it's got a good message that you can really latch on to.
Then we have Careless. This is probably my least favorite on the album. This song is, you know, the lyrics are self-destructive and hopeless. He talks about just going around doing things that are obviously not good for him, like drinking a bunch on a Monday and calling all his ex-girlfriends, all an attempt to feel less and less. I don't really love the message, and the song isn't as catchy as some of the other songs.
Yeah, I totally get where you're coming from. I wouldn't really know how to feel about this song when I listen to it again. I think it's catchy. All the songs are catchy, and this isn't like an exception of like, this isn't, you know, on the same level of quality. But I agree, it's just like, they're usually so good at those heartfelt messages that, you know, kind of catches you off guard when this one isn't that. I don't think he's like saying we should all do this, obviously, but, you know, it's a little bit of glamorizing, you know, yeah, like you said, that self-destructive lifestyle. That, yeah, it's probably not one of my favorites, but it's still got some catchy hooks, as always.
Yeah, I mean, it's hard to put down any song on this album, because they are all really good. The second to last track is Till I Don't. This song is pretty wholesome to me. It's not your average love song where the lyrics are all about how long the love will last and how they're perfect for each other. It's just about hoping for the best because you really like the person, but not really knowing where it's going to go or if there's a good chance of it lasting long.
I agree. I kind of forgot about this song, but listen to it again. I think this is one of the strongest. I just think the melodies and the instrumental go such a long way and are elevated by some great lyrics that are also really interesting.
All right, last song on the album, and we're gonna cap it at this 12th song, because they do have a deluxe version, but it has 20 songs, and it's just a little long for what we're going for today. If you want to check those songs out, I'm sure they're super good. I don't know them as well. But the last song we'll talk about here is 1 Minute Left to Live. As long as you're the one I'm with, if I had just 1 minute left to live. Lany always knows how to end a record. I really like how slow it gets and how real it gets right here. This song talks about the common thought, what would I do if this was my last day? And the answer to that is he would want to spend his last minute with his person, you know, the person he loves, and that's just because that's what makes him feel complete. So I think that it's a very wholesome, good feeling song, even though some of the lyrics, you know, can sound kind of scary, a little sad. It's really beautiful to me.
I agree. The song is super wholesome. It's another one where it slows way down. I think it sounds a little bit like kind of different from a lot of the records, since it is so synth heavy throughout this record. This one's just piano driven, and they've done piano stuff before, but yeah, I think it just closes it out on a really subtle note. And like you said, they always write some interesting lyrics that paint a new story every time.
All right, so let's talk about this album as a whole. I think that GGBBXX by Lany, their newest record, is definitely a hit. It has some great songs. It's all very catchy and well put together. I've listened to their album before this a little bit more, which is why I'm more familiar with those songs. But that's not to say that the album is better than this one. I think that they're both pretty on par with each other.
Yeah, I don't know if you could make a call on which one's better. They're kind of like a package deal for me, since they came out so close together. I think that both of these records are just super good on the same level, and I appreciate their differences. Obviously, this one's more synth heavy, with, you know, sometimes more energy, but I just really like them both, and I think that they just wrote so many good songs in a row, and they're just like, we got to put all this out, and it was definitely the play, because all these songs are really good.
All right, well, now we're going to move into the games portion of our podcast here. Games. We're going to be playing Matthew McConaughey or Lyrics, and so, Matt, all of these that I'm going to read to you are either something Matthew McConaughey said or a Billie Eilish lyric quote. Okay. Right. So the reason I've put these two together is because Matthew McConaughey is an actor known for saying lots of strange things. And Billie Eilish also has some kind of wacky lyrics. So Let's see if you can tell the difference. The first one is going to be, life is a road, I need to keep moving.
Wow. I have several things to say. First of all, it's going to be really hard for me because I haven't listened to very much Billie Eilish. Second of all, that just reminds me of Life is a Highway. Obviously, there's no denying that. They just need to keep going? Is that what it was?
Yeah, life is a road. I need to keep moving.
McConaughey.
It is Matthew McConaughey. Yeah, the reason I chose Billie Eilish is because I know you aren't super familiar with her lyrics, so it'll make it a little bit more fair. But that's good. You got the first one right. All right, the next one is, water is never clumsy.
You know, that's a little bit too metaphorical. I'll go Eilish on that one.
That is also Matthew McConaughey. I have no idea what he was trying to say there.
Okay.
This next one is, I put on Survivor just to watch someone suffer. And Survivor here is the TV show Survivor. So I put on Survivor just to watch someone suffer.
There's no way. That's got to be McConaughey. There's no way.
That's Billie Eilish. That's a Billie Eilish.
Does it work in the context of the song?
Well, the song is called TV. Okay. And it's off of her. She just released two singles called Guitar Songs. And
it's not really
but there's reference TV's mentioned shows. Yeah. Okay, so you're 1 for 3 right now. We'll see if you can make it up. Now we got, if you want thicker hair, don't cut it when the moon is waning.
What? The moon is waning. I don't know, something about the moon waning is like edgy enough for Eilish, you know.
Yeah.
I don't know. I guess I'm going to go Eilish.
That is Matthew McConaughey. That is something Matthew McConaughey said.
Well, he does like his hair, so I should have seen that coming.
Yeah, he is a big hair guy. All right, I'll give you one more, and then we'll end this. I don't know. Next time, maybe you'll do a little bit better. I was worried that these would be too easy, but now I'm seeing they might be a little too hard. Okay, let's see. I have a few here. Let me pick a good one. Okay. The last one I'll do is, vanity is a great motivator.
See, looking back, some of these I should have been able to tell. They were just the way they're formatted, their lyrics, but this is too short. I don't know. I'm going to go Eilish again.
It's Matthew McConaughey, man. I'm sorry. Why is he saying weird stuff? I don't know. I literally just typed in funny Matthew McConaughey quotes. That's and funny. They were endless, all like this.
That's good.
Okay. All right. Well, you didn't do great, but to be fair, it was almost impossible to tell. All right, everybody. Thank you for listening to this episode of Disc Review. We had fun talking about the newest Lany album, and we hope that you'll stick around. Please subscribe on YouTube. If you're listening through Spotify, you can follow us there as well. But yeah, we'd love to hear from you and talk to you about music. Thank you.